dodge. I let the fear take the wheel and steer.
Session and I got a notification to say it's Are You Okay Day today. It's 12:06 on September the 14th. I know it's obviously this isn't a two-way thing, you guys aren't talking to me. I'm just talking to a camera technically right now, but chances are there's gonna be one or two of you that are watching this. So yeah, you know, are you okay? And if you're not, feel free to reach out to me. Honestly, my DMs are always open. I'm more than happy to talk to anyone about anything. If you're struggling, if you're just going through a rough patch, if you're just, you know, not feeling yourself, just, you know, reach out to me. I'm more than happy to hear what you're going through and just talk to you about it, because honestly, you know, I've been in positions where I feel incredibly confined within my own self, and I feel like it's really hard to express what I'm going through. But even just, you know, breaking the ice and just saying, hey man, you know, I'm not feeling too good right now, I just need someone to talk to. And even if it's just to take your mind off things, you know, that can help so much. But just know that there's always someone that is willing to listen to what you're going through. It's honestly, that's the most important step. And it's the bravest thing you can do for yourself. And I care about every single one of you, even though I might not know a lot of you, you still take the time to watch my videos, and that just means the most to me. So yeah, I just hope you guys are all okay. Life can get hard, life can get stressful, trust me. The battles that go on up here sometimes can just be overwhelming. Take it one day at a time. I feel like we all overstress ourselves, we all overwork ourselves. It's good to just take a deep breath, one of those big... Just chill. You're doing good, trust me. You're doing well. Gonna go and surf. Well, I'm gonna go surf. This guy isn't, he's gonna spectate. You'd sort of assume, since I've got blonde hair and I'm Australian, you'd be like, damn, this guy's a really good surfer. Well, you're wrong. But have a crack.
Improve.
Yeah, exactly.
Work on
exactly.
Your craft.
Work on the craft, improve.
If you like this, I mean, get better.
And appeal to that alien male standard. And little tour of the place that we're at in Byron. Come out here. You don't really need much more than this in terms of living. Very personal, you know, you come in here and you literally have all you can eat brownies. So if you're bulking, perfect. Coffee, machine, all the goods, all the stuff you need to be a happy human being.
You're right. Back again, turn to the right. Back turn. Yeah.
Bottle of jugular of water. Alright.
Morbic.
Make sure I'm in this. Alright, we're at Water Goes in Byron Bay. Just came down here because these are some very good waves to learn to surf on.
Alright, this is how I've been taught by the master behind the camera. Paddle. Search. Scurry.
Fucking out zoom this. Oh yeah, perfect.
Do, 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 do. I have held in my heart a heart to have enough.
Maybe I just wanna be your. There's nothing quite like just coming to a beach, sitting down, just taking in the serenity next to this fucking shit on his phone.
Fucking.
Take it in, huh?
I'm working
take it
on
in.
My foot.
No, you're not. Your foot's there, mate. You want to work on your foot, you can wiggle it around. He's stumped. Doesn't know what to say. Look at this fucking beast.
Cody's that. Cody's this. Cody's me, bro. Let me be me. When is that going to start?
Where do we go?
Google?
G-Y-G.
Google?
Google? I have 20 cents. What can I get
what
for this?
What can I get, buddy?
Can I get one string of pulled beef?
Yeah, bro, you good? Nah, it's a fucking video game. A little screen video game, eh?
Yeah, you have love in it. You have
love. Go to clothes. Just kissing my
face.
I got a fucking chode of a fucking burrito.
It's like the size of my index finger. Danny pulled out because he's a fat little shit. Do you want the chippage?
Yes. Yes.
Where are we living, right?
Take this time on my pre-workout, makes my skin itch to just, you know, conversate, talk about diet and stuff around that. Also, what a fucking beautiful day. Come on, if the sky is blue, why the fuck are you sad? Come to a point where I've realized something. If all your external factors are good, if, you know, the weather's good, you have no reason to be sad and you still feel like shit, chances are you're just putting that on yourself. That's something that I've realized. You're in control of your emotions at that current point because nothing externally is impacting you, unless there is, obviously. What I'm saying is if you're just like, I just don't feel good. Like, I don't understand what it is. Like, why am I feeling this way? There's so many things that you can do in that situation. Go for a drive with music. Go to the gym, hit a fucking good session. See your boys. Just do something. When you're in that depressive state, melancholic, for whatever reason, you can get yourself out of it by doing just something that you know will make you feel better. For me, it's just going to the gym. Even just going for a walk outside, meeting up with one of my mates, just having a laugh. Even just calling them, being like, okay, I feel this way. Let's actually do something about it. Like, so many people get just wrapped up and consumed with the thought that they can't get themselves out of their situation when 9 times out of 10, well, especially for me, I feel like if I don't feel good, I'm just feeling sorry for myself and playing the victim card and just being like, whatever, I guess I just don't feel good today. Well, mate, you will feel better if you do something that you feel good doing. And that's something I guess I need to remind myself, because sometimes you just wake up and you just feel like shit and you're like, what the fuck? Why are we doing this today? I was so good yesterday. And then today I feel like absolute donkey balls. But sometimes your mind is literally the biggest motherfucker to deal with. It'll just be like, you wake up, you know, I had a good 7-8 hours of sleep. Fuck you today. Reverse a whole thing and be like, I'm gonna have a fucking good day. Then you walk outside into your kitchen, into whatever living space you have, chuck your speaker on, put your headphones in, start bumping some music and tell me you don't feel like a million bucks. Unless you have like a 15 hour shift that day, you're gonna start that day well. Then boom, off to the gym, hit a session. It's already 10 o'clock, ready to attack the rest of the day. Go and do your uni work or whatever you have to do. Just get it done. And then call one of your boys up. Oi, I don't know, anything. Just like, just be proactive about it. If you just sort of open and gloat about it, then, you know, you're only gonna feel worse. So, yeah. That was probably the most unexpected, spontaneous yap possible. About what I was actually gonna talk about. So my diet. I follow like a 90-10 rule. Well, maybe 80-20. So if I can be in control of my diet and make it as good as possible, then I will. But it's like if I'm with my mates or if I'm out on a weekend or
just feel like having a shitty meal, then I'll have one, because at the end of the day, you don't need to be so strict and regimented all the time. The way that I look at what I put into my body to fuel my body, people say, oh, your body's your temple, your body's a house. I guess I sort of do live to that ideology. Everyone knows the feeling after having a Zinger box. You just like, what the fuck has happened? During it, unreal. I could eat this every single day. And then 20 minutes after, it's like a form of PNC, post-nut clarity. It's post-Zinger box clarity. You want a tangent again. Pretty much, I associate eating better foods with feeling better, functioning better, sleeping better, overall feeling better. After, you know, having a salad or something healthy, you feel great. My philosophy is, why would I not just want to feel like that after every meal? It's not hard. It's so easy to do. You know, some of the meals I make, you know, protein pancakes, smoothies, oatmeal, like there's so much stuff that you can make that is great for your body. Nutritionally dense, keeps you fuller for longer. Yet people are just like, oh, if I want to eat healthy, it has to just be plain chicken and rice. It's like, no, at the start, it's hard. You know, oh, this is doesn't taste as good, but you're able to sort of chop and change. You find out what things work for you, what things don't. And then you get to a point where it's so easy for you to do. It doesn't feel like I'm really actively trying to eat healthy. It just becomes the norm, you know, and your body starts getting used to these foods more and it starts tasting better and better and better because you get used to it and you're not used to eating all this like processed junk food that your body used to crave. If you can prioritize it at this age, it's going to be so much easier to do it down the line. It's not going to feel like, oh, I need to diet down. You're just always going to be sort of on point. I'll take you into the Aldi and I'll just sort of run you through some stuff that I get. It's pretty basic, like it's not very exciting, but yeah, anyways.
What's wrong with you?
So yeah, as you saw, just a whole lot of this shit. Some mango, some bananas, blueberries, a bunch of potatoes, sweet potato, and then just a bit of almond milk as well. But yeah, that's pretty much the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you guys, you know, got something out of it. Just gonna, you know, keep cracking on. Definitely, obviously this video took a bit longer to get out than expected. Planning to get out on the weekend, but I just sort of, you know, spent time with my mates and just was pretty wrecked by the end of it. So back to posting at least one video a week. That's sort of the schedule that I want to stick to, just to keep that consistency up. If you have questions, if you have topics you want me to go over, I'll probably leave a little poll on my Instagram story as to like what sort of topics you want me to go over in future videos. It'd be really good if you guys could sort of just, you know, give me some recommendations about what you want me to talk about, because I feel like I've got a lot that I want to give and a lot that I want to share in terms of gym or even just life related, you know, how I deal with certain situations and stuff. I feel like I'm really passionate about, you know, talking to people and helping people and sort of giving my insight into your situation if you need advice on something. And yeah, I know, I gain a lot out of it because I learn, you know, about myself and I learn about how I deal with things. And when I actually have, when I get asked a question, it's like I actually have to think about it. And yeah, I don't know, it's constructive for both of us, I guess. So yeah, leave me some comments, you know, DM me or whatever. And yeah, just on that, obviously, are you okay thing. Obviously, it's not going to be are you okay day when this video is posted, but that doesn't mean anything, you know. It shouldn't just be like one day a year where we have to ask our pals, are you okay? It should just be, you know, whenever, wherever. So yeah, you know, reach out to me or anyone if you are sort of just feeling stressed or anxious or whatever. And yeah, anyways, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in the next one.